Welcome to science class. In this video, I am going to explain about conductors and insulators in the chapter electricity. Why do the electric linemen or wear rubber gloves in their hands while doing electrical works on a electrical pole? We know that all materials are made up of the basic building block, the atom. An atom contains electrically charged particles. Many of these particles are fixed to the atoms, but in conductors, such as all metals, there are lots of particles that are not held to any particular atom but are free to around the randomly in the metal. These are called free charge. Conductors and insulators. Based on the property of conductance of electricity, substances are classified into two types, namely conductors and insulators or bad conductors of electricity. The electrons of different types of atoms have different degrees of freedom to move around. With some types of materials, such as metals, the outermost electrons in the atoms are loosely bound, and they disorderly move in the space between the atoms of that material. Because these virtually unbound electrons are free to leave their respective atoms and float around the space between the adjacent atoms. They are often called as free electrons. A good conductor is one that has lots of free charges, while those who don't have enough free charges would not be good at conducting electricity, or we can say that they would be poor conductors of electricity. Conductors. Conductors are the materials whose atoms have electrons that are loosely bound and are free to move through the material. A material that is a good conductor gives very little resistance to the flow of charge on the application of internal voltage. This flow of charge is what constitutes an electric current. A good conductor has high electrical conductivity in the above activity. In general, more the free electrons, the better the material will conduct for a certain applied voltage. Insulators. Those materials which don't have enough free electrons are not good at conducting electricity, or we can say that they would be poor conductors of electricity, and they are called insulators. An insulator gives a lot of resistance to flow the charge during the trip of the electrons in an object. When an external voltage is applied, collisions occur between the free electrons and the atoms of materials also affect the movement of charges. These collisions mean that they get scattered. It is a combination of numbers of free electrons and how much they are scattered that affects how well the metal conducts electricity. The rubber eraser does not allow electric current to pass through it. So, rubber is a non-conductor of electricity, that is, rubber is an insulator. Most of the metals are good conductors of electricity, while most of the non-metals are poor conductors of electricity. In this figure, some metals are given which act as good conductors. Iron, aluminium, metal sludge, bronze, steel and copper. In this figure, some of the insulators are shown. Any material that does not allow electric current to pass through it, plastic, rubber, glass, wood and cloth. This is the material used in SIM cards, computers and ATM cards. Do you know by which material this chip made up of? This chip which are used in SIM cards, computers and ATM cards are made up of semiconductors, namely silicon and germanium. Because of their electrical conductivity lies between a conductor and an insulator. Wires made of copper and electrical conductor have low resistance. Copper wires are used to carry current in households. Enclosed in electrical insulators are materials of high electrical resistance. These materials are usually made of flexible plastic. Short circuit. We might have observed the spark in the electric pole located nearby our house. This is due to short circuiting of electricity. Along its path, a short circuit is simply a low resistance connection between the two conductors supplying electrical power to any circuit. Arc welding is a common example of the practical application of heating due to a short circuit. Students, I hope you have understood about conductors and insulators. Thank you.